In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of chest muscles. There are basically two muscles, right? I'm going to explain their basic anatomy, functions, and important myofascial connection. First muscle is, of course, this one, this big chest muscle. This is pectoralis major, pec major. Pectoralis major. If there is major, there should be minor. Pectoralis minor. I'm going to explain pec minor later. Okay. Pec major. Big chest muscle. Big shoulder muscle. It originates from clavicle, sternum, and part of ribcage. The insertion is humerus. It's very big muscle. Then you can divide pectoralis major for three parts. This is upper fiber, middle fiber, and this part is lower fiber. Function of pec major. There are numerous functions. First one is flexion, shoulder flexion, and adduction. Adduction is like closing arm. This is adduction. Next one, internal rotation. Internal rotation and horizontal adduction. Horizontal adduction is you put your shoulder kind of 90 degrees, then you cross shoulders. It's like dumbbell fly movement. Okay. Easy way to remember. Horizontal adduction is like dumbbell fly. So this is basic function of pec major. Now let's go to a little bit more detailed anatomy. Because pec major attaches to clavicle and sternum, there's something to do with clavicle movement and sternum movement. Thus, when pec major gets tight, that also inhibits movement of clavicle and sternum. Not only shoulder movements, but why is that important? What is problem if clavicle movement and sternum movement are inhibited? When you want to move shoulder joint, your clavicle needs to move together. Like you can feel it, you try to move shoulder, then your clavicle must move together. If you break clavicle, it's very hard to move shoulder joint. Clavicle and sternum are articulated. Articulated means there is joint, there is junction. Thus, you can say sternum is also related for shoulder movement. Let's see. Sternum has articulation with clavicle. Clavicle has articulation with scapula. Scapula is articulated to shoulder. See, there's one continuous bony structure, continuous joint structures, right? It's very common that if there is adhesion of myofascia around sternum, sometimes shoulder joint movement is inhibited. It's very common. Thus, not only around shoulder joint, I oftentimes focus on around clavicle and sternum. This is very important to know. Now let me explain relationship with other muscles. Again, this is pec major, very big muscle. Let's go to the other muscle. That's this one. This is also big shoulder muscle. This is deltoid. Deltoid, particularly anterior fiber. Anterior fiber. Pec major and deltoid are very close. It's like neighborhood. They are facing each other. There's almost no separation between these two structures. It's only tiny bit space here. Then there's only vein running this space. So it's almost no space, no separation. Thus, again, if pec major gets tight, deltoid is oftentimes affected. Deltoid can be tight with pec major because they literally close each other. Vice versa, if deltoid is tight, pec major can be tight as well because it's connected, it's facing each other. This connection is very, very important. You should not separate these two muscles. Well, this is basic anatomy of pec major and related muscle. Let's go to next one, pec minor. Okay, pec major and other shoulder muscles are gone. You see pec minor, pectoralis minor. This is important for scapular movement because it attaches to ribcage and coracoid process, rib 3, 4, 5, and coracoid process. This muscle moves scapula. There's three movements. One thing is scapular abduction. Scapular abduction. Downward rotation. Downward rotation and depression. Oh my gosh, so many movements for scapula. Scapular movement is important for shoulder. As I said in pec major part, if sternum doesn't move, clavicle doesn't move. If clavicle doesn't move, scapula and shoulder doesn't move. Plus, since pec minor attaches to ribcage, there's something to do with breathing. Huh, it's interesting, right? So if pec minor gets tight, that also inhibits breathing. So it's like pec major. Pec major also attaches to ribcage plus sternum. Do you remember that? If pec major gets tight, that somehow inhibits breathing. Very important. These two muscles are sometimes not classified as breathing muscle. However, if you think about their attachment, they attach to ribcage. Yeah, they attach to ribcage. So they have something to do with breathing. This is important to know, right? Anyway, pec minor, important for scapular movement and ribcage movement, breathing. Does it make sense? Now, let's go to important myofascial connection related to pec minor. There is myofascia covering pec minor and anterior chest. This fascia is clavipectoral fascia. It's deep to pec major and it's above pec minor. It's deep to pec major, and if you remove pec major, if you dissect pec major, clavipectoral fascia shows up. It's covering pec minor. It attaches to coracoid process, clavicle. And it's like this. It's kind of a contour of pec major. Clavipectoral fascia is like this. So when this fascia gets tight, that may inhibit movement of pec major and pec minor. That makes sense. Now, let's check a myofascial connection from clavipectoral fascia to other place. As I said, clavipectoral fascia attaches to clavicle. Then this fascia continues to fascia of subclavius. Fascia of subclavius. Then this fascia of subclavius goes posterior to clavicle. It goes posterior of clavicle. Then this myofascia continues to go to anterior neck. So from clavipectoral fascia, it goes to fascia of subclavius, goes to clavicle, to anterior neck. Does it make sense? I'm going to say it again. Clavipectoral fascia to fascia of subclavius, subclavius to clavicle, clavicle to anterior neck fascia. Then what can you say? If clavipectoral fascia gets tight, that of course inhibits scapular movement, breathing, of course. Then that can inhibit clavicle movement, if you follow my fascial connection. Then it can inhibit movement of neck. Vice versa, if anterior neck gets tight, that may be able to affect for shoulder joint movement if you follow myofascial connection. See, chest muscles are so important. It's not only for joint movement, but it's important for myofascial connection. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.